Hello, wellness warriors. Welcome back to the Entheogen Explorer channel, where we share the latest and greatest happiness hacks with you. I'm Caitlin Thompson, your host. So in a previous video, I talk about glutamate excitotoxicity, which is basically when you have excessive amounts of glutamate binding activity in the brain. In this video, I'm going to share with you six natural supplements that have been scientifically studied to mitigate and prevent glutamate neurotoxicity. So just to give you a little refresher, glutamate is an excitatory neurotransmitter found in the brain, and it is made from the amino acid glutamine. Now, glutamate is important for a number of different processes such as learning, memory, cognition, neuroplasticity, and propagating action potentials in neurons. When there is excessive amounts of glutamate binding activity, a neuron can become overexcited, and this causes damage to the cell. This is most often prompted by chronic immune and inflammatory dysregulation, which can be caused from brain injury, chronic infection, stress, or exposure to toxins. If you want to dive deeper into what glutamate excitotoxicity actually is, be sure to check out the video that I've already made. Click on the info card above and check it out if you want to learn more. Now, in summary, excessive glutamate binding activity is bad. So here are six natural supplement substances that have been scientifically found to mitigate and protect against glutamate excitotoxicity. L-theanine is a naturally occurring amino acid found in green tea. It has amazing calming effects and has been known to take the edge off of the caffeinated experience of drinking tea. Now, L-theanine is actually an analog to glutamate, which means that it shares the same molecular skeleton backbone as glutamate. For this reason, it can interact with some of the same receptors as glutamate. Studies have shown that L-theanine blocks the NMDA glutamate receptor from being activated by glutamate. Compared to other potent glutamate blocking drugs such as MK-801, L-theanine performed just as good at reducing neurotoxicity from glutamate stimulation. Curcumin is a flavonoid found in the turmeric root. Now, if you want to learn more about turmeric and curcumin's benefits, check out this other video that I made that goes deeper into that. So, curcumin is a potent anti-inflammatory and antioxidant boosting molecule. Because research suggests that inflammation is one of the driving factors for the development of glutamate excitotoxicity, curcumin's ability to reduce inflammation and lower pro-inflammatory cytokines is really important for its neuroprotective and regenerative properties that help combat against the damage from glutamate excitotoxicity. Curcumin also upregulates the production of a powerful antioxidant molecule called glutathione. It also reduces the amount of lipid peroxidation end products, which can cause oxidative damage to cells as a result of glutamate excitotoxicity. And it also upregulates BDNF, or brain-derived neurotrophic factor. BDNF is a protein that prompts the growth, repair, and regeneration of neurons and neural structures such as synapses and dendrites. Resveratrol is a flavonoid found in red grapes, and like curcumin, it has potent anti-inflammatory and antioxidant boosting properties. This makes resveratrol super effective for mitigating the oxidative damage and inflammatory results of glutamate excitotoxicity. Resveratrol has also been found to increase biogenesis of mitochondria. Mitochondria are the energy-producing organelles in a cell, and when a cell has low energy production, it may respond by increasing the sensitivity of the glutamate receptors. Also, as glutamate becomes more excitotoxic to the cell, damage can occur to the mitochondria, thus further lowering the amount of energy production from the cell and increasing the amount of sensitivity to glutamate. So what happens is you get trapped in this vicious cycle where the mitochondria is being damaged and not producing enough energy, and the glutamate receptor sensitivity is increasing to account for that and damaging the mitochondria even more. And it's this progressive feedback loop that ends up ultimately developing into neurodegeneration, which we see in things like dementia, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, and other cognitive decline conditions. There's a number of different studies that suggest that DHA is the most potent neuroprotective omega-3 fatty acid out of all of them. DHA is also an incredible anti-inflammatory agent. Much of our brain tissue consists of fat, and DHA is the most abundant fatty acid found in the cell membrane of neurons, and specifically synaptic spines. One study found that brain cells treated with DHA and exposed to AMPA glutamate receptor activation had a neuroprotective effect against glutamate excitotoxicity. Another study found that DHA inhibited microglial immune activation in the brain as a result of ischemic brain injury. It also found that DHA increased the amount of protective cell factors that were neuroprotective against cell death. Magnesium is a critical nutrient and ion for over 300 different biochemical reactions in the brain and body. Magnesium deficiency alone can induce inflammation by increasing cytokines like TNF-alpha, interleukin 1 beta, and interleukin 6, all of which have been known to prompt the increased sensitization of glutamate receptors. Magnesium is also particularly important for modulating glutamate receptor sensitivity because it sits and acts as a block in the pore of the NMDA glutamate receptor and stops the influx of calcium from coming through the receptor into the cell and creating activation. When there is magnesium deficiency, we don't have magnesium to sit in this pore and block it, and this results in the ability for calcium to flow into the cell and activate the glutamate receptor. Ashwagandha is an Ayurvedic herb that has been used traditionally for thousands of years. It's considered adaptogenic and is also antioxidant boosting and anti-inflammatory herb. In one study, human brain cells were pre-treated with ashwagandha extract or saline solution and were exposed to a glutamate challenge. And what they found was that in the samples that were treated with the ashwagandha extract, there was significant neuroprotection from the damaging effects of the glutamate challenge. There was reduced biomarkers indicating reactivity to cell injury and the presence of neurodegeneration. So while the effects of glutamate excitotoxicity are certainly detrimental, luckily nature really does have our back and offers an abundance of resources for us to combat, prevent, and heal from glutamate excitotoxicity. I've only mentioned 6 different natural substances that you can use for glutamate excitotoxicity, but the reality is that nature is full of them. There are a number of different herbs, nutrients, amino acids, and other substances out there that combat against the damaging effects of neurotoxicity by glutamate receptor activity. If you're looking for a supplement that will help you balance your glutamate receptor sensitivity, look no further. Check out Transcend, our best-selling product on antheazen.com. It has 17 scientifically studied ingredients, including 4 of which I just taught you about in this video. And it was neuroscientists developed with the intention of mediating glutamate activity to some extent. So check it out. There's a link below if you want 20% off your first purchase. Doesn't hurt to try it, just give it a shot. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe so that every week you don't miss a beat and I can continue to share health and happiness hacks with you. Love you guys. Smile on, my warriors. Mwah.